Hi, I'm Colin Goff.
And I'm Owen Lytle.
And we're back, baby! Bearcat TV, back better than ever.
We got a lot of new and exciting things to show you guys.
So we're going to start first with Corbin Harshbarger's unique take on movie reviews. Woo! By God, it worked! I am Time Travel Corp! I have survived World War III by taping my lower torso back together. I have hunted thousands of creatures. Goblins, gnomes, leprechauns, golems, clowns, and mice! I'm still single, ladies. I know, it may be hard to believe. I am a bit of a hot commodity. But I can make it work, maybe. Oh. I've come here to stop a terrible event. Movies in the future are so bad that people just die when they watch them. They drop dead. They just drop dead, and they're dead forever, because that's what dead means. It's gotten so bad that President Scrumbumbilo has issued a ban on film or something. I've come back to your dumb past year to find the root of this problem. Weed it out! So let's go see what we can find. Baby, wasn't weak.
What's the best movie you've ever seen?
Flowers in the Attic.
Looking good,
dude. Alright. Yeah.
What's your favorite movie?
The Titanic.
Amateur hour over here. Amateur hour.
We have a king here. Since he's a king, of course, he has. His opinions are a lot more valid than others. What's your favorite movie?
My favorite movie is probably the Into the Spider-Verse movie. Yeah.
What's your favorite movie?
Well, sir, I like this movie called Okapilandia. It's about this giraffe-looking thing. But what it's supposed to do in the movie, it goes around killing people, but he's the hero. They're just killing off all the vegetables.
Hey, can I have an interview?
I don't know.
Can I have an interview? Hey, can I have an interview? Why does no one want to talk to me? Can I have an interview?
I've been lied to.
Why does no one want to talk to me? Guys! We need to... Does anybody want an interview? No one's talking.
I might be beaten in my quests. What's your name?
King George V.
Oh, what's your favorite movie?
I'm more into old westerns, so you know me. Lion King.
Let me see the microphone.
I just want to see.
This is the microphone.
I have something to
what
say.
Are you telling me? This is
insane. This is $1,000 of priceless time travel material.
Well, that was interesting.
Yeah, that's definitely unique.
Next, we'll be going into 10 questions with Mr. Noble.
All right, I'm Bearcat TV. This is Mr. Goff, I'm the advisor, and I'm here with Mr. Noble, our brand new agate teacher here, and we're gonna have our Bearcat 10 questions with Mr. Noble. You ready?
I guess so.
All right. First question, the easy one. Where are you from?
I'm from Albion, Nebraska.
Albion, okay. All right, who is your celebrity crush?
Ooh, celebrity crush. I'd probably go with Cameron Diaz.
Cameron Diaz.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, since you work with animals, do you have a hard time eating hamburger or steak?
Nope, not at all.
Not at all, okay.
Nope, not
okay.
A problem.
What is the home cleaning chore you are bad at?
Dishes.
You don't do dishes.
It takes me like a week or two to actually sit down and do all the dishes.
Oh, that's
nasty. I can't do it. I know. It's nasty, but I can't do it.
All right, all right. Does pineapple belong on pizza?
Nope. It does not.
Hi.
Nope.
Come on.
There's some vegetables that belong on it, but not pineapple.
But not pineapple?
No.
What does it mean to boiler up?
Not Purdue fan here.
I don't know, because you have to, you know, share a room with Purdue fan, so.
I do have to share a room with Purdue fan. That takes some work.
It's hard.
It takes some adjusting.
I get that. Yeah,
it does.
You know, we all have to get that with a Purdue fan around here. All right. Is there such a thing as a vegetarian or vegan farmer?
There could be a vegan farmer. You could grow your crops, but not use any animal livestock products whatsoever.
What would you say if a guy said, "I'm a vegan farmer"? What would you your reaction?
I'd probably scoff a little bit. I'd laugh just a little bit, and I'd probably want to know what his viewpoints are. Right. I want to see where he's coming from with that one.
Right.
Yeah.
What's your current Netflix binge?
I've been watching this new show called You.
You.
Yeah, but I also watch The Walking Dead a lot. So
yeah. Okay. How good are you at line dancing?
I lived in Lincoln, went to UNL, and they have Playmore there Sunday nights.
Playmore night, yes.
So you could go dancing on Sunday nights, and I actually went to that a lot.
Were you good at line dancing?
I can line dance,
could you rip out, if we go to a segment, and you're going to have line dancing with Mr. Noble, could you teach that?
Yeah, cut to that right now.
Okay, cut to that. We're going to do it. Cut to line dance.
Not yet.
Okay.
Oh, you're doing that one. Oh, that's a complicated one. I'm just going to do the...
You not know that one? Oh snap, so you go right, right, left, left, right, left, cross, over. Oh, it works either way. I've learned both.
All right.
Look at that.
There you go. Okay, how many times, our last question is, how many times have you been asked, are you a student?
About once a week, if not more. There's been times I've been asked which class I'm headed to, and I'm like, well, mine. that's a problem.
But right.
We're hoping I'm gonna look a little older as time goes. Won't be 22 forever.
There you go. I was 22 a long time ago. Yeah. All right, thank you, Mr. Noble, for a Bearcat 10, and we'll see you back here. See you guys.
Thank you.
Scootin' Boogie, good time.
Next, we're going to the library to learn about Rubik's Cubes and shapes.
Yep.
In the library for the next 6 to 8 weeks, we have 600 Rubik's Cubes available. These are through the Rubik's Cube Lending Program. It's called You Can Do the Cube, and schools or educational organizations can get them for a 6-week time period and have them available for their students. They can get different kits, anywhere from 25 to 600. So I went with the biggest one, thinking with our population at our school, it would be a big project for us to do together. So there are different mosaic designs that students can do, and the one we're starting out with is the Statue of Liberty, and we have to get every cube to have a certain design on top, and then it will create one gigantic mosaic image. So after we finish this one, we'll mix up the cubes and then plan to do a large big K for Kearney High, and the art department's working on creating a pixelated design for that will follow. And after that, we'll also create in 3D a bookmark that a student has designed that's done in pixels as well. So we'll create a 3D version of that bookmark using Rubik's Cubes.
Can't wait till that's finished. Now we'll be moving on to Josh Garlds and a new Grind My Gears segment.
You know what really grinds my gears? This weekend, we had two football games, NFL football games, the AFC Championship and the NFC Championship. Both games, refs screwed everyone over. Let me tell you, Patriots, Tom Brady is the GOAT, I understand that, but you can touch his shoulder when he's throwing a football. Why is that a call? Now, I didn't watch that game because I was too mad about the Saints-Rams game, but that's just what I saw on social media. Now, let me tell you, pass interference, that's a call I feel is a little judgmental. You can have it either yay or nay. You know, sometimes you can't see. Sometimes the refs are in a bad position. That being said, sometimes calls are just obvious. Trip someone, runs into someone, has his back turned and runs into a wide receiver at full speed. Not only runs into him, runs into his head. That's two penalties, pass interference, targeting. The refs miss both. They call that the Saints taking the three times. Saints go on to the Super Bowl. They don't call it. The Rams win the game. The Saints got screwed out of a season. How much does an NFL ref get paid? $201,000 to screw up the Super Bowl. Come on, guys. We're better than that.
Josh, thanks for telling us how you really feel.
Now we'll be heading to the weight room for some weight room stereotypes.
Man, these planks, dude, they are killing
my back.
Man, I'm so sore from my CrossFit workout yesterday. What are you gonna do with CrossFit?
Let's go. Okay, Bearcats. If you want to keep up with what we're creating, check out and subscribe to the following links.
Have a great day, and don't forget, we are Kearney High.